I've been asked to speak about Eretz Yisrael. This is a tough key which is too big for me. Eretz Yisrael is big. The only heter I have to speak about it that I'm a ben shel kedoshim, so I have this yichus to be able to speak about Eretz Yisrael. Maybe a little credentials. My elder Zayda, Rav Atzadik, Baruch David Kahn, is Eretz Yisrael for Brocha, and his son, the Chosid. And he was the Shaliach of the Divrei Chaim, a Kodosh, to set up the Kila of Chasidei Tzan in Tzvas, and the Minyanam, 1863, my family came to Tzvas. My Zayda Nachman Kahana was born here, and my elder Zayda Zayda put up the shul, the Sons of Beis Medish, which is functioning today in Tzvas, never stopped. And my father was born in Tzvat, Yecheskel Shragar Kahana. And during the First World War, when everything was horrible in Eretz Yisrael, when the Turks retreated, my grandfather, Nachman, took my father to learn in Galicia, where the family came from, in a town which had three names. The Jews called it Uspitzin, the Polaks called it Oświęcim, the Germans called it Auschwitz. But there's a Hasidic community there. Two-thirds of the people Jews. The yeshiva, Yeshiva's name was Yeshua Bambuk, and my father learned there for several years. And then he came to America and was Rav in America. I came in 52 years ago, and the question is, the same question, which I posed to you, why did I come? The same reason I'm asking you to come. I came for several reasons. I see that we were in Golis, the worst punishment Hashem could have done. We were Golis Mitzrayim for 210 years, and Golis Bava for 70 years, and Golis Edom for 2,000 years. Something changed. Something changed. We have today in Eretz Yisrael almost a majority of the Jews in the world. Over 6 million Jews in Eretz Yisrael. It means something happened in the world. And the Kas is over, I believe. I think that the last Kas, anger, was the Shoah. I think this Kodesh Baruch Hu is going now. No Hester upon him is going away. Now the time has come to come home. The natural place for Jews in Eretz Yisrael. The government is yes from, nish from, that doesn't matter. The government is like a piece of clothing. Today it's this, tomorrow it's something else. Eretz Yisrael remains what it is. And Mama Rochel, Novi Yomi always says a Perek Lamed Aleph, Rochel cries, Babakeh Abaneh Kehenenu. Children are not here. Now the chance to come home. And we don't have to look around. This person, that person, everyone has to see himself. We all live in a limited time frame. We all have 120 years. Come before the basement Shamal and he say, what did you do in the world, life that I gave you? Well, I lived in Muncie. I lived in Williamsburg. I lived in Eretz Yisrael. Sounds differently. And here, when you come here and you guarantee you and your children and great-grandchildren forever and forever, they've come home to Eretz Yisrael, the Matona. And every person has to look at time inside himself and see, Taka, what did I do in this world? When you come to Eretz Yisrael, the Zoreiach says that every country, every nation, Yeshivim, Yeshivim Amin, there's a cholon, there's a chalon, a window, and a malach, which is Muna in every one of the nations. Eretz Yisrael is tachat kisei hakavod. There's no chalon, there's no windows, no malochim. Here you come under kisei hakavod. That's all I can say to you, that Kodesh Baruch Hu have almost a majority of Jews in Eretz Yisrael. When you become a majority, then everything becomes doraisa. Shum becomes doraisa, Shemitah becomes doraisa. We're very close to that. And here the Torah is going to live even more than it lives today. Not Hashem.
Why do you think now, more than ever, Jews from around the world should make Aliyah?
I think that we're reaching now a time of where things are coming to a head. I wrote about a raya, but I'm going for all the things. Gemara says in Megillah that Moitzi Shviyis, that's the time of Gula Bam Yisrael. Shviyis is Mochomis. And that's why in Shmonesrei, the seventh bracha has to do with Kula. this coming year, Tovshin INA, which is Loshin Teshua, which is Gula, can be a Mochomis. We see it in front, we see it in front of us. The time has come now, I feel, that the Navi says, Ba'atzion Tia Pleita. Ba'atzion is going to be a refuge. If you're not going to be here, then you're massacring yourself and your family. No one knows what's going to be in Chutzaretz. Ha'atzion, Ha'atzion, we have a guarantee. Yishmael is getting stronger, and he's facing Yitzchak. Everything is coming to a head now, east and west, and then says Yishmael and other things, and Esav is coming to a head. And you have to be here in order to be guaranteeing yourself and your family. Even though on paper it may look that the United Israel is surrounded, the Chondas don't birth, doesn't matter. But Lamaisa, we have Avtocha, of Novi Yoel, another place that said, Ha'atzion, I mean, Eretz Yisrael, your Plato will be a place richer for the Jewish people. I, in Eretz Yisrael, you don't ask a person how long you've been here, ask how many wars have you been here. I've been here 8, 10 wars, depends how you define it. Every war I saw, Yad Hashem. I was also in the army over 22 years, in Miloim. I was in the Air Force, but Nunmem, anti-aircraft. I was in Sinai every year for 30 days. I say, Yad Hashem, my children. We see it every war, the last war, every soldier speaks about Nisim in their lives. The very fact that we live here, the last almost 70 years in Eretz Israel. We started from what? A little country on the edge of the desert, nothing here. My father told me when he was born in Sfas, to barely anything to eat, Bachlau. Take a look. It cannot come about in a normal way. This is the Yad Hashem. Everyone feels it. Even the Chilonim. Today, a Chiloni today, I remember I went to a taxi the other day, and he says to me, you know, I put on tefillin every day. I don't drive in Shabbos, but I'm nilo dati, I'm not from. That's the way it goes. It's very difficult never to sort to make a line from nishfrum. You can, there are certain extremities. But the rank and file of the people are Mesoratim and they're getting more. I dare say with every Muhammad we get from it, we get proof to closer. The greatest human experience in the world is to be born a Jew, a Yid. And the greatest thing that a Yid can do himself is to come live in Eretz Yisrael. Doesn't matter where, doesn't matter what you do. The Musag, in my opinion, the Musag of Chiloni doesn't exist here. Whatever you do here, paving a street, planting a garden, and by definition, it's kadosh. That's what it is. I call out to all my brothers and sisters of Chutz Laaretz, and I was there with you. I know what it is. There's one difficult thing about coming to Eretz Yisrael. One. And that's the moment of decision. Once you decide, then you have Siyata Dishmaya. And I'm not saying it's easy. I'm not saying you come here, Panosa is easy. I'm not saying everybody is Panosa, Baruch Hashem. Works out. Think about yourself and your family. Klal Yisrael, in Chutz Laaretz, you live in communities. Here you think in terms of I'm an Am. That's a different mindset. A member of an Am Yisrael, not just a community. It makes a big difference.
You can't ever get my message for the organization, Zoreiach, for the Oilam in New York, for the Chasidim.
The organization is a bracha mi'ashem. Everything has its time. So 50 years ago was not its time. See, now is the time. And these young men that came to me today, they only say, Cheskuv v'imtzuv me'ashem should give you strength, mashpi and other people. But remember, there was the Aliyah of the Chasidim. When the first Aliyot Eretz Yisrael, Aliyot of Chasidim. Chasidis, Avas Eretz Yisrael, Avas Am Yisrael, that's natural to Eretz Yisrael. What a chosid does things, lifnei Meshur Sadin. Coming to Eretz Yisrael is not lifnei Meshur Sadin, it's the din, it's not lifnei Meshur Sadin. And it starts the bamkeit of a chosid. It's full of Ahava. If there's Ahava, it's in Eretz Yisrael. And I wish you success. Bring people, whoever you bring here, from the Matzah Nefesh HaChas B'Yisrael, you'll get more.